Soaring high above the beautiful cityscape and bright lights of Atlanta. Happy to have you with us for NBA basketball on 2K Sports. Joined by Chris Weber and Grant Hill, our reporter Allie LaForce, this is Brian Anderson. Hey, Allie.
Hey, Brian. We've heard a lot of critique of some of the fouls that are called. Ask Warriors head coach Steve Kerr. He said, quote, "We've gotten out of control, gifting offensive players the ability to jump 3 or 4 feet into a guy and draw a foul. It's not a basketball play. Give the defensive player some benefit of the doubt, guys."
All right, Allie, good stuff there. Makes a good point. All right, let's take a look at some numbers for Desmond Bain.
He's been playing a larger role in their offense over the past 5 games. And we see that in his usage rate, which has gone up during that stretch. We'll see if they continue to lean on him here tonight.
And the starting lineup for the Grizzlies. Jackson Jr. and Adams together inside. Desmond Bane is out there with Ja Morant. And it's Anderson in at the three, the small forward. And for the Hawks, in the backcourt, Young and Bogdanovich. Jeremy Grant out there with John Collins. And it's Gibson in at the five, roaming the paint. And talking end-of-season awards, Chris, for Defensive Player of the Year. Why do you think no guard has won it since Gary Payton in 96?
Well, because no guard has been as intense as Gary Payton. There's never been a defensive point guard like Gary Payton. You kind of have to know Gary to understand how crazy he is to want to defend the best guards 94 feet. But no, Gary Payton was just a special player. It's going to be hard to see players have that impact in the game.
Collins against Anderson. Pass to Bane. The three is up. Fires in the triple.
Now, this is the attitude Anderson brings. A selfless player who loves giving it up to his open guys.
Here's Atlanta with the ball. It's a three-point game. Up top, Gibson. Back to Young. Outside, Bogdanovich. Kept alive by Atlanta. Grant finds Young. Over Morant. And Young, the bucket on the assist from Grant.
The mid-range can be tricky for Young, but he was clearly feeling that shot.
Here's Morant. Pass to Adams. Hangs in the air. Shot's good by Morant.
Just taking it right to the rim. And no one was there to greet him.
Yeah, very little resistance. I mean, you had to bring much faster help than that.
The Hawks have gone 1 of 3 from the floor. Out of bounds. And it'll go to the Grizzlies.
Memphis ball.
Just around a minute and a half into this first quarter. Outside, Anderson. To the middle. Kicks it out to Jackson. From deep three-point range, Memphis the rebound. And he makes it.
Straight-up effort gets him those points. That's what it's all about on the offensive glass.
Young, the pass to Graham. And it's Collins.
That's how you feel?
Oh, okay.
Oh, an explosive leaper who plays with good energy. Collins can make some real athletic finishes.
There's the AT&T 5G slam can, capturing the moment. Memphis has gone 1 for 2 from beyond the arc in this first quarter. You know, Grant, it seems like Collins is one of those guys you can depend on for a 2010 stat line just about every night.
Yeah, he's a double-double machine. He's as consistent as they come offensively, and with his hustle, his rebound numbers are never lagging.
Trey, he said jump was
Memphis' first personal foul.
All right.
John, first team foul.
With the explosiveness.
Shooting to Memphis.
Living the lane and soar to the Raptors.
Two shots.
And relentless is Moran. Man, does he attack the paint, Chris.
As fast as he is, he does a great job of using change of speed. He keeps the ball on a string, and when he gets it in close, watch out. He can finish any way he wants to.
The free throw drops for Morant.
And what really separates Morant? The intangibles. He has a great camaraderie with his teammates already.
On both.
Yeah, and one thing that impresses me about Ja Morant is the leadership he exhibits. Loves the game, plays with toughness, and the results speak for himself.
Now here's Young, a dangerous offensive player. His scoring average stands at almost 30 a game. That shot, no good.
A rare miss for him at point-blank range. That's one he'd like to have back.
On the wing, Bane. Pass to Adams. Down low. Here's Moran. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take two free throws. That one on Young.
One thing Morant does with consistency, I mean, he keeps defenders off balance.
And Chris, the drafting of Morant has accelerated the Grizzlies' rebuild. Even as they've gone young, they've remained competitive.
Well, he's the face of the franchise, and I think his maturity and humility, along with their other guys, is what's helping to keep this Memphis team on track.
And the first one at the line is good. Williams has checked in for the Hawks. And Morant drops them both.
He's making the most of every trip to the line, providing for his team.
The Hawks trailing. Pass to Gibson. Williams against Morant, and it's Williams off the drive. Yep, that one goes. Here's Morant. Really played well against Indiana in his last game. Here's Bane. Outside, Anderson takes the three. The rebound by the Hawks. They just couldn't come out on top last time they took on the Grizzlies. That one was in Memphis.
Last time, free throw shooting was their kryptonite. Just could not keep pace.
Now, here's Williams. And right now, he's currently putting up 6.5 points per game. Adams with the ball. Morant, the pass to Jackson, and it goes as the official calls the foul. Count it, and he'll shoot one more at the line.
Well, you hear the term wingspan, more and more. You look at Jaren Jackson Jr., 6'11". It's his height, 7'4". Fingertip to fingertip, that's his reach. And that reach enables him to be a major factor defensively.
Falls for Jackson, and in the past we've heard the Chris Bosh comparisons for Jaren Jackson. C-Web, you buying that?
Yeah, I see some similarities in the game. Jackson, a rangy open defender at 6'11", with a nice face-up game. Bosh, maybe Serge Ibaka. Good comparison.
Now here's Williams. 8 points in his last time out, and the shot goes. Williams has got his second bucket of the night.
In the NBA, you just can't let guys get to the rim.
Now Morant. Pass to Bane. Jackson with it. Just five to shoot. Shoots over Collins. Tries again. And that one goes in as he's fouled. It'll be 3 points if he converts the free throw.
Thank you.
And let's quickly check out the scoring breakdown here for Memphis.
They're just a team in sync right now. Their passing in the first half has been outstanding.
Another positive has been their play in the paint offensively.
Gallinari, he's checked in for the Hawks.
And you have to be impressed how they're getting to the free throw line and taking advantage of those opportunities.
Out left to the wing. The rebound by Jackson. For Memphis, they've gone 5 of 9 from the floor. Here's Bane. A chance to extend the lead to double digits, but it's no good. The Hawks have gone 4 of 9 in this one so far. Pass to Bogdanovich. The teardrop. Adams grabs the miss. Adams has got 4 rebounds now. Here's Bane. Williams defending. Adams with the ball. Back to Morant. From downtown. And it falls. 2 for 3 from the field so far.
Boy, I like their energy coming in. Terrific execution so far.
Going for the juggler right off the bat. I mean, jumping out to an impressive early lead.
They've been having major problems offensively.
Definitely in a bit of a dry spell.
And here's Bogdanovich. 14 points for him last game against Charlotte. Driving in. Kicks it out to Collins. The Hawks need to get one up here. Here's Williams. Second shot opportunity. And Collins lays it up and in. Collins has got his second basket of the game.
The contact wasn't going to hold Collins down. He explodes into it and finds the shot.
So it'll be 2 free throws. He was fouled in the act of shooting. Well, Grant, you've won the NBA Sportsmanship Award 3 times, tied with Mike Conley for the most ever.
Wow, no, it is a humbling experience to get voted for that award by your peers. You know, it's all about, I think, trying to play the game the right way with integrity. And Conley is a guy that truly embodies that.
First free throw is good.
And I love how they've been the aggressors on the offensive end. So unafraid of contact, looking to score points in the lane and at the free throw line.
Okongwu checks in for the Hawks. Herter comes in for Bogdanovich. So he gets them both.
The multi-talented Jackson is impressed at an early age, mainly because his game is perfectly tailored for today's NBA.
Now, here's Williams. Gallinari, the pass to Graham. Here's Okongwu, and he drops in the layup off the glass.
Second chance points are always painful. Have to make the effort to box out.
Yeah, that's what's frustrating, because you did the job defensively to get the stop, and then you gave it right back.
Moran against Williams. Moran into the lane, and then Moran with the dunk!
So far, they're owning both ends of the floor. We'll see if they can keep this going.
Yeah, we got to be careful. It's still early. They've expended a lot of energy, but they've also built a nice cushion here.
Timeout called. The Hawks. And these have been the league's best shooters since the All-Star break. Steven Adams on top. Fourth, Jaren Jackson.
It's been a shooting clinic from these two ever since the break, making confident selections and just shooting the lights out.
The Hawks have got 6 of 14 in so far. Williams finds Gallinari. There's the three. Herter gets the bucket.
Pick works well there, but the defense left a lot to be desired.
It's a lazy effort. Let's just be honest. Hoping the shooter misses, that doesn't constitute defense.
Now here's Moran. 11 points in the game. Count that one. Jackson's got 7.
Defensively, their effort hasn't been great early on.
Here's Herter. From the arc. Can't hit that one. Now Memphis takes it the other way. Fresh off a win against the Pacers.
And guys, those road games are never easy. But they had a solid strategy going in and stuck to what they do best.
Staying with your game plan is so important, especially when you are away from your home arena.
And just not letting up at all. I mean, you have to love this approach. You want to get the ball to the guys who make plays.
You have to go to your best scores. I mean, it's a smart strategy, and so far, it's paying off this game.
Now here's Gallinari. Well, he hasn't scored yet, but I'm sure that'll change. Grant's shot is off. Memphis has gone 3 for 5 from deep so far in this matchup. Pass to Bain. Now here's Anderson. And he was camped in the lane there. He gets a 3-second call. And with the playoffs around the bend, here are the Western standings. You look at the Grizzlies. They're in the pole position right now for the top seed in the conference.
Right now for the Grizzlies, they're peaking at the right time. They can really feel it. The big question is, can they keep this momentum moving forward?
One thing's for sure, they're about to find out that regular season pressure is no match for the playoff pressure.
On the money from 12 feet away.
This team looks to him to score the ball. They feel good when he's taking the shots.
Now here's Moran. He's got 14. Pass to Bain. Moran with it. Picked up by Gallinari. Shot's good by Moran. 16 points for him.
Only one miss in his first 6 shots. He's definitely brought his A game.
Atlanta's gone 1 for 3 from outside so far in this game. Here's Okongwu. Right side, Williams. And it's good for 2. Williams has got 6.
Terrific design and execution, leading to an opportunity right at the rim.
Pass to Bain. Now Jackson. Back to Bain. It's tipped. Here's Gallinari. Checking his stats, he's scoring around 9.5 points per game. Shoots over Anderson. No good off the back of the rim. And here's Memphis, leading by 12. For 3. And again, it's the Grizzlies from deep.
Outstanding long-range shooting here early. They already have hit multiple shots from downtown.
Williams with it. He's got 6. Pass to Herder. Oh, a clear foul there on the missed shot. So he'll get a pair at the line.
At the line for your Hawks, Kevin Herder. I count 2 shots.
And he knocks down the first one. Wright's checked in for Williams. And that's good as he hits both shots. Timeout called. Memphis.
And something fans don't always get to see, some of the closely guarded secrets that happen in that huddle.
Yeah, and sometimes it's the most subtle move
that makes a noise.
Some changes. Brooks, he's checked in for Anderson. Melton comes in for Bain. And it's Jones in for Moran. Memphis has gone 4 of 6 from deep to start this game. Brooks outside. Back to Jones from deep. Rebounded by the Hawks.
So far, rebounding has been a focal point. for them.
Well, Grant, the best way to steady a team, have an anchor like Tyus Jones as the backup point.
I mean, just an outstanding decision maker. His steady play complements their athletes with that second unit.
And a look here at the scoring trend over the last several months for Jeremy Grant.
And he's been trending downward in terms of his average points per game, and a number of reasons can lead to this. But he needs to figure out how to get back on track.
On the wing, Brooks. And he drives in. Oh, it's stolen. Herter with it. And Melton picks him up defensively. And there's a whistle. That goes on DeAnthony Melton. That's his first foul of the game.
Yeah, he tried to gain position, but couldn't quite get there.
And how about the mobile one block we just saw? Amazing defensive work.
You know, you can't ask for any better defense than that. He responded so fast to the shooter, and it stifled him.
Outside, Gallinari. A minute 39 left in the first quarter. Right, and that's good. His first bucket of the game.
They just look so overwhelmed inside. You know, that's why they continue to get attacked.
Melton outside. Back to Jones. Pass to Jackson. Adams with the ball. Here's Jones. They grab their own miss. And it's Adams missing. Atlanta's gone 1-for-3 from outside so far in this game. Here's Grant. And a miss there with a chance to cut the lead to single digits.
And he's having an ugly quarter from the field. It seems really frustrating.
Outside Jones. 4-3. He buries it from three. And the Grizzlies lead by 14.
They've really built this lead on the back of their perimeter game.
Oh, yeah, they certainly found something along the perimeter. Just an onslaught of three-point bombs.
Now here's Graham. He's coming off a 25-point game against the Hornets in Charlotte.
I mean, look at his free throw numbers. I mean, it shows you how much pressure he put on the defense.
Melton outside. Brooks outside. Pass to Jackson. Second chance effort. And Adams lays it in. Adams has got 7 points.
And the defense has no one to blame but themselves. I mean, they just let him get right to the rim.
Yeah. Horrible effort. It appears they may be on the brink of giving up.
The effort has to be better defensively. Easy deuce.
And the dunk by Jackson.
This is the aggressiveness Jackson provides. Give him the right positioning, he'll finish with strength.
It doesn't go for him. And a double-digit lead on the scoreboard as we end the first quarter of play. Grizzlies out in front. They lead by 14. And we'll be back in just a minute with the start of the second quarter. And the fourth pick in 2018, Jaren Jackson Jr., the rare NBA-ready defender, he talked about where he can make the most impact.
Probably be more of a backline help, talk more, give more help for the rotations because, you know, depending on what team you play, there's a lot of specific things you got to do to guard a certain player.
A veteran's understanding of help and positioning, Grant.
Yeah, I love that defensive mind approach. That's why they're a team to be reckoned with.
And so far through one quarter, it's been a lopsided game. We'll see if that changes here in the second. And the Grizzlies have been rolling along, haven't they?
Well, it's simple. I mean, they started off strong, and they've been hot from beyond the arc since the get-go.
Defense spinning in circles. Hard to cover all that ground.
Taj Gibson is out there with Danilo Gallinari. Then there's Kevin Herter. Then it's DeLon Wright. And it's Young in at point guard. So that's the Hawks five. All right, let's check in with Ali LaForce.
Hey, Brian. The Hawks went on a tear last season after naming Nate McMillan their interim head coach. After he won Eastern Conference Coach of the Month and helped guide them to the franchise's first playoff run in four seasons, it seemed inevitable that he'd become the head coach long term. Guys?
Nothing new for him, Allie. Good stuff there. Adams has gone 4 of 5 from the floor. Just the one miss. Puts one up from 19. Boy, clanks that one off the back iron and it falls. Young's gotten his second bucket on the night.
The scoring ability of Young is just unreal. It's what's made him an all-star.
Inside, here's Adams. It's good. And he drew contact on the shot, so he will go to the line. A three-point play opportunity. Well, C-Web, congratulations are in order for being elected into the 2021 Basketball Hall of Fame class. Man, it's been a long time coming. Congrats.
Oh, man, thank you. I'm so incredibly thankful to everyone who supported me over the years. Shout out to Sacramento Kings. You know, I'm just honored to be recognized among the greatest to ever do it.
The free throw drops for Adams.
There have been more than a few NBA players out of New Zealand, but Adams will always be able to brag that he was the first Kiwi ever picked in the first round.
Now here's Young. 20 points for him last game against the Hornets in Charlotte. Morant against Young. Morant, no good. The Hawks have got 2 of 3 shots to go in the second. Here's Bogdanović. They get the rebound. Deflected!
And blocks like this fire Anderson up, which in turn get his teammates going as well.
To the inside, Gibson, and he goes up strong with a one-handed jam.
And this is how unselfish Young is. When he sees an open teammate, he gets them the rock.
Young against Morant. Jackson outside. Pass to Adams. Just 5 on the clock. Memphis needs to get off a shot. Takes a 13-footer. Collins with the rebound.
Couldn't quite line that one up. Just got to shake it off and move on to the next one.
Up top, Young. Pass to Gibson. And here's Wright from the arc. Counted from distance. Wright's got 7 points.
No, he just caught the defense napping. He shoots a very high percentage from three-point range, and there's no hand in his face.
Here's Morant. Oh, there's Morant with the slam.
Man, I love watching this kid play. Morant, he's just electric at the offensive end. He's having a night.
Atlanta's gone 1 of 2 from downtown here in the second. Young against Morant. Collins outside. Off the mark. Had a chance there to trim it to single digits.
Nice rebound. Trying to match the other team's intensity right now.
Outside Morant. Pass to Adams. To the paint. And the jump by Jackson.
Slams it down with two hands.
Man, they're really getting aggressive now. Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. Now here's Wright. To the middle. Oh, it's stolen by Adams. Here's Jackson. And it's good. Fought through contact. Hit the shot and will go to the line. And the Hawks making a change here. Williams has checked in. And Memphis also making a switch. Tillman's checked in for Adams. The Hawks have gotten 4 of 8 shots to drop in the second. Now a timeout called by Atlanta. They're moving on after the tough loss they took at the hands of the Hornets.
They just weren't careful with the rock. The passing was loose. The ball handling was lackluster. That's not how you win in this league.
I mean, they were their worst own enemy in that game. I mean, they kept on shooting themselves in the foot.
The Grizzlies making a switch here. Clark's checked in. Just over 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. Williams passes to Bogdanovich. To stop the run. Another shot. Tipped.
Well, I'm surprised he's still out there. He's been invisible at the offensive end all game long.
Pass to Bane. Down low. Here's Tillman. Oh, and a beautiful feed leads to a monster jam.
Well, part of the game plan was to neutralize the crowd. And guess what? Mission accomplished.
Their poise has been tremendous. Being excellent at both ends has them increasing this lead.
Collins finds Bogdanovich. And there's the lob. And then it's Collins with the dunk.
You've got to admire the awareness that Bogdanovich possesses. I mean, solid at realizing when the D has left someone open.
Pass to Bane, launches it, and a great assist by Morant as that one goes. Morant's got 4 assists in the game.
And give their offense some love. They've been the more efficient team.
Yeah, and it's because of the looks they're getting. Their offense is creating some great opportunities.
Up top, Gibson. Off with the layup. The Grizzlies have gotten 7 of their first 9 shots to drop during the second. And he dunks it down.
But this is why Morant's teammates love to play alongside of him. I mean, exceptional vision, and he's incredibly unselfish.
Now Wright. He has 7. And C-Webb, you look at Desmond Bane out of college. An NBA-ready physique right out of the gates.
And his game is NBA-ready as well. I mean, he's played significant minutes already. He's a reliable perimeter threat.
And the basket by Clark.
That's been typical of their performance today. They're sharing the ball and creating good shots.
Offensively, it's been a struggle for them.
Yeah, they need to string together some shots to have any kind of chance.
And here's Collins for 3. Buries it from 3. Collins has got 9 points.
They're making a few more 3s this quarter, trying to cut into that deficit.
Clark outside. Pass to Tillman. Left side, Moran. Here's Bane. Right with a steal. Good D by Clark. And here's Memphis. They're on a 16-5 run. Shot's good by Moran.
Timeout.
Moran's got 20 points.
I just love the ball movement.
Time called here. The Hawks decide to talk it over. Boy, you gotta like what Ja Morant has done in this game.
He's been a thorn in their side all game. They'll probably use this timeout to change up their D. The system they're in now, it just isn't getting it done.
Atlanta making some changes here. Okongwu comes in for Gibson, and Grant is subbed in for Wright. And Atlanta has possession. They'll be playing host to New Orleans for their next one. That'll be the second of a 2-game stretch at home. Outside, Williams sends it home from 3-point land. He's got 9.
One of his go-to shots. Williams is terrific at finding space on the perimeter and sinking it from deep.
Pass to Bane. Outside, Anderson. Now here's Moran. Williams defending. 4 on the clock. Takes one from 10 feet. Clark, no good. Atlanta's gone 4 of 9 so far from the perimeter. Grant outside. Gets it to go. His second make in 6 tries.
They're punishing those late defensive rotations, getting good looks inside throughout the half.
Anderson against Grant. Outside Morant. Ooh, poked away. It's stolen by Bogdanovich. On the push, here comes Atlanta. Collins controls the rebound and the putback. Collins has got 7 points for the quarter.
He's done everything he can tonight, trying to keep this team competitive.
Inside, here's Tillman. Oh, no good! Unable to end this run. Atlanta's got 3 of 5 to fall from beyond the three-point line in the second. They get it again. Pass to Bogdanovich. Jacks up a three. Ooh, that's got to feel good. That basket makes him 1-for-8.
He's taken 5 shots this quarter and only hit one.
Grizzly timeout.
Say ouch to that.
Timeout called. Memphis.
Yeah, they're hoping to turn things around with this timeout.
Yeah, they have to regroup and revisit their strategy at the defensive end.
Herder's checked in for the Hawks. Memphis has gotten 6 of 10 three-pointers to drop. Pass to Bane. And he gets it to go. 4 for 6 so far.
With the run he's on in the second quarter, I mean, this field goal percentage is tremendous right now.
Now the Hawks with it. They're on a 13-4 run. Baseline try. Williams misses. Well, the Grizzlies' shooting has been unreal. 64% from the floor. Here's Clark. Good. And the setup by Morant. Morant's got 6 assists now in the game.
That's just the product of good pass work. I mean, nice team basketball right there.
Atlanta's gone 4 of 7 from three during the second quarter. Collins outside. Williams up top, pounded by Moran. Pass to Herder. 6 on the shot clock. Oh, nice finish from the low block. That one's good. Herder's got 7.
Gotta fight harder to get over those screens.
We see this all too often. You have to be willing to put it.
Now Anderson. And here's Morant outside. Collins with the rebound.
Well, he had 2 3-pointers in the opening quarter. And hasn't been able to connect yet here in the second.
Let's the three fly. And the three-pointer goes. Herter's got 5 points now in the quarter.
And that's a defensive lapse. A shooter of his caliber can't be left wide open.
Here's Bane. A 26-point game for him and the win against the Pacers in Indianapolis.
This system is set up perfectly for him today. I mean, it's allowing him to find a lot of good shots.
And so it's Atlanta with it. They trail by 14. And here is Williams. Outside Herder. The kick out to Williams. Great look there, but off target.
That's the shot they wanted. It just didn't fall.
No, you're right. He'd take that 10 out of 10 times. You're not going to miss many of those.
Here's Bane. Herder defending. Pulls it. Rejected by Okongwu. Tillman. Atlanta with a rebound. Here's Williams. Excellent D there from Morant. Memphis has gone 1 of 2 from downtown here in the second. There's 1:26 left in the first half of basketball. Okongwu with the rebound. Okongwu's got his 5th rebound in this one. Collins, the open look. Kept alive. To the wing on the left. Grant outside. It's Williams, high post. And too long on the shot.
Things can turn around in a hurry. I mean, can't they?
Last quarter, he was lights out. All of a sudden, nothing's dry.
Basket counts.
John Morant.
Morant's got 22.
Oh, working through the lane, Morant. Use his change of speed to keep defenders at bay.
54 seconds left in the first half. Now here's Williams. 9 points in the game. The Grizzlies pull it in. Tillman's got 5 rebounds tonight.
It's been a really tough quarter for him. His shot.
That was nasty. A two-hand mega slam.
Man, I don't think anyone was going to stop him there. 36 seconds left in the second quarter. They're searching for a way to score.
Yeah, buckets have been very tough to come by.
Williams with it. Into the lane. Their offense stone cold. Another miss there. Memphis has gotten 6 of 11 threes to go in this game. Back to Tillman. Well-timed pass, and he goes straight to the bucket for the layup. Tillman's got 4 points this quarter. Now Williams. From deep three-point range. Oh, got it off in time, but it's no good. And so it's Memphis, ending the quarter with a 20-point edge. It hasn't taken them too many shots to get their points. They're winning with efficiency. And don't go far. We'll be right back.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello, basketball fans. What a pleasure it is to bring you into the 2K studios again. Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith. It was all Ja Morant in the first quarter. He ended up with 22 points, 4 rebounds, and 6 assists. Kenny, what'd you think about the Grizzlies?
Well, they're getting to the line more, and that usually comes down to wanting it more. Because once they had the lead, they kept pushing. They tightened things up, and they didn't let go.
And over to the big fella. Your thoughts on the Hawks?
Definitely they need to get out on the three-point shooters and contest. Balls. This is what happens when another team identifies your weakness. It just keeps hammering you.
And that'll do it for us. The third quarter about to begin with Kevin Harlan standing by. We'll catch you on the flip side.
My brother.